Hi everyone, my name is Maria and today I'm gonna be doing the AuthorTube newbie tag. This tag was created by Janice Treaty. I will link her video below in case you wanna do it yourself. So, let's get on with the questions. The first question goes, how did you find out about AuthorTube? Well, when I came across my first AuthorTube video, it was around early 2016. I had recently finished a YA fantasy novel. And it was my fourth novel, and I thought maybe I want to get this one published traditionally, so I went to YouTube for information, as you do. Like that, I came across my first AuthorTube video. I think it was a Mandeline video. I will link her channel below because her channel has so much information on self-publishing and also traditional publishing, so you can't go wrong with her channel. I think you'll really love it. If you haven't followed her already, in that case, what are you doing? Anyway, the second question goes, what genre do you write in? Well, I write fantasy, high fantasy, and poetry. I am actually working on a sci-fi fantasy. It's been giving me a headache, but I am determined to finish it. So I guess I should also add science fiction to the mix. Although I don't think science fiction is the right genre for me. The third question is, what is your preferred writing tense, point of view, and category of story? My preferred tense is past, and my preferred point of view is third person omniscient, and my category story, I guess, is young adult. The fourth question goes, are you a plotter, a pantser, or a planser? I want to say I'm a plotter because I do write an outline. It's just that I end up not following that outline, so I guess I am a planser. Fifth question, are you self-published, traditionally published, or yet to be published? I am yet to be published. Whether that is self-published or traditionally published, we have yet to see. But for now, I'm trying to get traditionally published. If that doesn't work out, then I'll go back to the original plan that was self-publishing. On to question number 6. What publishing company, literary agent, and or printing company are you represented by or use? If not published, what is your dream publishing house and or agent? Tough question because, you know, to be quite honest, I don't think I have a preference there. I think as long as they distribute your novel well, that's the main reason I will traditionally publish. If they can do a good job distributing my work, then that's actually all that matters to me. On to question number 7. What AuthorTube related videos can we expect to find on your channel? I'm gonna be posting NaNoWriMo updates, videos about querying, the process of querying, about your query letter. That's something I actually have to work on, so we might work on that together. So videos about writing, and if I do decide to self-publish, I guess I'm gonna document that. I would like to post book reviews, but I am the slowest reader ever, so don't really expect much of that. I mean, I can take about a month to read an average-sized novel. So yes, I'm the slowest reader ever. On to question number 8. When did you start writing? I initially started writing songs when I was around eight years old, but stories and poetry, my first poem I wrote it when I was 11, and after that I didn't write poetry for a long time, and so my first story was when I was in 7th grade, but after that I didn't write stories for a long time either, so I want to say I started formally writing when I was 18 years old. Question number 9. What was the first story you ever wrote? So, given how shy and introverted I am, it's gonna sound weird to hear that my first story was a horror story. I wrote it in 7th grade. We had to write a story about a legend. It was for Spanish class, and I went with a horror story. Yep. Question number 10. What authors have inspired your writing the most? I want to say Isabel Allende. I actually started writing because of her novel. I'm looking at it right now, I don't want to show. I'm gonna look for it. This is it. It's La Ciudad de las Bestias. I actually started writing after I read this trilogy. Like, this book is magic for me. I absolutely love it. It's my favorite book in the world. This book is actually my favorite book in the world, and how pretty it is. After I read this book, it was the first time I thought I wanted to write a book myself. I wanted to write a story that made readers feel the way this book made me feel. In addition to Isabel Allende, I would say another author that really inspires me is Catherine Fisher. I absolutely love the way she writes. She writes beautifully, and she not only writes novels, but she also writes poetry. On to the next question. It goes, do you schedule your writing sessions or simply get to writing whenever you can find the time? Well, it depends. I sometimes schedule my writing sessions, but usually I just write when I have the time. When I'm really not motivated to write at all, I schedule my writing sessions so that I can actually get some writing done, because if I don't, like if I wait to get in the mood, it's not gonna happen. I'm not gonna write anything that day. So. Question number 12. Do you type everything in a computer, typewriter, write everything out by hand, or use a blend of those? And where do you write in general? I use a blend of those because I have a notebook for every project that I'm working on, but I usually write everything on the computer. You know, my dad used to have a typewriter, but I used to play with it when I was little, but I would not write or recommend writing on that because at least my dad's typewriter was really difficult to type in. It's great to have a notebook for your project so that you can type down your ideas if you get an idea and you're not home with your computer to write it down. And on to the final question, question number 13. What are you most looking forward to now that you're a part of AuthorTube? Well, I'm mostly looking forward to making connections with people, with fellow writers who are in the same boat as I am, and also potential readers who might be interested in reading my stuff eventually in the future. They might find me through YouTube, as I have found many new authors through YouTube. So I think YouTube is a great place to make connections, to forge a relationship with potential readers and with fellow authors who are also trying to get their work out there. So that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. I linked Jenna Street's video down below if you want to check her out. And if you want to see more from me, I'm gonna be posting regularly, I hope. So please subscribe and like this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye. I have all the questions written down in this cute ice cream notebook.